the NASCAR Veterans Memorial Coliseum in Uniondale, New York, Sports Channel brings you New York Islanders hockey. Tonight, the Islanders play host to the Chicago Blackhawks. Hi again, everybody. I'm Jake McDonald with Ed Westfall, Dan Fischler in our studio as the Chicago Blackhawks and the Islanders meet for the first time this season. Chicago comes in a tie for first place in the Norris Division on a .500 record. Nothing better than that, despite the role they've been on recently.
A tough team. I think we have to look for a different kind of a hockey game than we saw against the Boston Bruins on Thursday. With the Bruins, it's generally more physical. With the Chicago Blackhawks, I look for more speed. They've got a lot of forwards that have some good speed, and they're used to being involved in a lot of high-scoring games, so there's always that particular part of the game you have to watch for also, that both these teams can score a lot of goals.
And if that isn't enough, they have the best uniforms in hockey, wearing the brilliant red Chicago Blackhawk uniforms here. We'll be back for the opening faceoff between the Islanders and the Blackhawks right after we pause for this message. Patrick Flatley out to Roger Corto. Couldn't pick it up at the Chicago line. Flatley has it. Has to wait for a man to get back onside. Comes over the line on left wing. Flatley gets tangled up on the boards with a check from O'Callaghan. Corto into the corner trying to dig the puck loose. Roger Corto comes out of the corner. The pass to Gillies, who's broken up. Now Gillies at point blank range, and Sobe down to make the save. Here's Corto in the far corner along with Gillies and a couple of Blackhawks, and they've managed to freeze the puck. Corner to Bob Murray. To Larmer. Larmer centers one across. That's cleared off Gimmick stick. Held in, however, by Doug Wilson. His long shot gets through and scores. Secord may have tipped it as he came in front of the net and turned. But the Blackhawks used the power play to take the lead.
It changed direction, and whether Secord deflected it or not, we'll have to wait and see. But Chicago, Wilson from the point position. Here's Wilson as he moves over in front of Bossy and Diddick. There's the shot. It went off Secord's right leg. It seemed to hit him on the shin pad and deflect into
it. Morrow, the Islander defense. Corto got the draw back to Boudelier, over to Morrow, then to Flatley. On to Corto. He's across the line working on Bob Murray. Corto at the side of the net to Gillies. He shoots, he scores! Mark Gillies comes back to tie it up in a pretty passing play with Corto.
Roger Corto doing a lot to make a pleasant known and seen. What a nice play as he stick-handled across the blue line, went into the Chicago area deep. Clark Gillies had the right spot. He knew exactly where to go. Here goes Corto as he crosses the blue line, makes the turn, and then drops the puck back. And the strength of Clark Gillies as he overpowers Rick Patterson, puts it into the net between the legs of Sobe, and it's 1-1. Clark Gillies getting his third goal. Pat Flatley and Corto will get assists on that goal.
Scored in the first period. We pick up the score in the second period. The Islanders, in a fine skating, a hard-hitting hockey game, get some good work. A guy that's worked hard all season long. Corto scores the goal to give the Islanders a 2-1 lead. Gilbert and Flatley assisting. But we talked about him. We talked about him all night. Andre Savard has great speed. He's got a tremendous shot. An unassisted goal by Savard at 37 seconds into the third period tied the score at 2 apiece. He was lost to the Islanders later on in the hockey game. He will not play in the game tonight, but he contributed in the hockey game. Pat LaFontaine, there's his pass to Clark Gillies. He steams through the center. Here's the shot by Flatley. Rebound by Gillies, and LaFontaine scores to make it 3-2 at 4:15 of the third period. The Islanders leading halfway through the third period. Pressure by the Chicago Blackhawks. A hard man to check. Al Secord, a healthy Al Secord. There's the shot into the net, and Secord from Savard, who had gone behind the net. The hard-working Savard tied the game at 11:38 at 3 apiece. Well, you think back, you have to think back a long time. It was about the 12th game of the season for the New York Islanders. They were in Toronto, and it was some affair, particularly for Pat Flatley. Therrien had scored twice, and then a natural hat trick. Don't see that too often by Pat Flatley. Maxwell scored, and we'll go to the third period, pick up the action. Or I should say it's late in the second period. the score tied at 3 apiece. Flatley has 3 goals at this point in the hockey game. As I had mentioned, there's a shot, a beautiful shot. He looked as much like Mike Bossy as Mike Bossy ever did. Flatley gets his 4th goal of the hockey game from John Tinelli at 19:19, late in the second period. That gave the Islanders a 4-3 lead. But Brad Maxwell, who at one time toiled for the Minnesota North Stars, rips a hard shot to the left of Billy Smith. And Maxwell, he reties the score at 4 apiece, 9:44 to the third period. Pat LaFontaine, who had another outstanding game going back to his 2nd game in the National Hockey League, where he had a high-scoring game. There's the play. Pat LaFontaine scoring at 14:03, making the score 5-4. And the Islanders squeak one out against the Toronto Maple Leafs November the 6th last.